Today I have a simple space-saving solution for any home. It's a dough-hung drying rack designed to save floor space, and it's super functional. To start off, I took a quick measurement of the door and the space behind it to determine the overall size. We needed at least 25-inch long drying rod and preferably more than 2 rows to hang our towels and a few clothes. Before getting into the build, let me show you the design real quick. It's a 2-tier design with 2 rods on each tier. There is a good amount of spacing between the rods to avoid overlap when you hang the clothes. Also, it can be hung over the door without the need to drill any holes. It's something important when you live in rental homes. Now, to build this, you need a couple of 1x3s, round aluminum spindles that are 26-inch long, and dough mounting hardware. First, cut all the wood pieces to required lengths. I have free plan and cut list diagram with all the dimensions on our website. The link is in description. Feel free to check it out. Once the cuts are made, I made pocket holes on both ends of the 8-inch and 25.5-inch long pieces. Also add pocket holes on one end of the 5-inch pieces. The other end is routed to seat the hanging hardware in flush level. Or you can skip this step if you don't mind little undulation. If you notice in the 3D view, the side arms of the 2 tiers are tapered in design. So I marked those angles and taped 2 similar sized arms together. This will help me to cut 2 identical pieces at the same time. All the items I use in this video are linked in the description below. Then I laid out my crosscut jig and used some scrap wood to set the tapering angle. Using circular saw, I made those long tapering cuts and cut the short ends with miter saw. Alternatively, you could also use a tapering jig on a table saw if you have one. Next, I'm marking the locations where the aluminum pipes have to be fixed. Making a 1/4-inch recess with a Fastener drill bit. Once all the cuts are made, I sanded all the pieces to smoothen the edges and moved indoors for the next stage. I decided to try a whitewashed effect on the wood so that it goes well along with the white painted doors. To do this, you have to mix water and white paint in 1:1 ratio. Apply the watered down paint on the wood and then quickly wipe it off with a clean rag before the paint dries. This will reveal the wood grains on the wood. If you feel the white is on a lighter side, then apply one more coat. I just did one coat on the pine wood. Once paint is dry, I sealed it with clear wax. This is great on such whitewash finished projects as it won't yellow in time like other sealers. Just apply with a good brush and wipe off the excess. Finally, assemble all the pieces together. Here is the finished product. If you want to build something like this, there's a link in the description below with plans and cut list. See you next week.